Hello guys, this is Sayed Muhammad Wakas. I'm here with another video. In this video I will tell you guys about duct routing preferences. Actually it is important to set your duct routing preferences because it will help you to create the same geometry of the duct as you want. So let me start this one. First you have to go to under system tab. You will find this duct, or simply type dt from your keyboard for the shortcut. Okay. Let me draw a duct from here, anywhere in the drawing, anywhere over here. Let me draw to show you. So from here let me draw a duct. Okay, like this, like this. Press escape once and draw a branch from here to here. Press escape once again and one more time press space. Okay, now if I select this elbow, you can see this a little plus sign over here. In order to convert into T, I can press this one. So just select this one, right click, draw a duct, one more branch over here like this. Okay, press K twice to cancel the command. Okay, this is how we can draw a duct. But let me change the shape of the duct by editing the duct routing preferences. Again, I'll go select duct. This time I'll go to edit type, from fittings, duct routing preferences, edit this one, and let me change this elbow. If you don't have any fitting, then you go under load family and then go to duct, and from fittings or rectangular or round, anywhere you can go there and select as many fittings as you want. So since I already loaded the families over there, so it's already there. So if I will select an elbow, this time if I want elbow to be like this one splitted metered elbow, okay, and preferred junction type, it will be tap. Okay, then first junction I want it to be beveled standard. Okay, second I want this Y curved standard, cross okay, transition okay, everything is okay. Just say okay and then okay one more time, hit apply, say okay. Okay, now I'm going to draw a duct one more time, and this time you will notice the shape of the duct will be changed because I changed the duct routing preferences. So one more time, from here to here, from here and here. Press escape once, draw a branch from here to here, and press escape twice to cancel the command. And now you can see that this takeoff over here is rectangular standard takeoff. Since I changed routing preferences, so it changed to be a beveled standard takeoff instead of this standard takeoff. Also, if you notice over here, the elbow is this radius 1.5 without any veins. But over here, if I will go and select this elbow is changed. This one is rectangular elbow, metered splitter, one splitter vane. Because I changed my routing preferences, that's why this elbow is changed. Or if I will select this plus sign over here in order to convert this into T, this will change to Y. Over here what happened? This T was like this, but over here convert into Y. So this depends on your duct routing preferences, how you want the geometry of your duct. So again right click and draw a duct from here to here. Press escape twice to finish the command. If I will select this elbow and go over here, property palette, if I will constrain this one, it will give me only one elbow which I select in my routing preferences. But if I uncheck this one, it will give me all other preferences which I can select over here. For example, instead of this one splitter, I will select two splitter. It will change to two splitter. Similarly, I can change to three splitter, whatever I want. For example, if I want to change this one to rectangular elbow meter double thickness veins, I can select this one and this elbow will be changed to rectangular meter double thickness elbow. So sometimes you have space restriction, so this is very important thing for you to know. So you can change this elbow from long radius to a short radius, or rectangular to some other elbows. So this is how you can change your duct routing preferences. I hope you guys learned from something from this video. So please like, comment, share and subscribe my channel.